Welcome to a new video. It's Ralphio. Today, this is my take on Kerby Jean-Raymond. I wanted to start a new series called My Take. It will be kind of a scripted video, kind of an essay video, whatever you want to call it. A little backstory of Kerby Jean-Raymond is that he's a Haitian-American designer born and raised in New York. Kerby Jean-Raymond created his fashion brand called Primos and founded it back in 2013, named after his mother. On the Netflix show Next in Fashion, he claimed that the reason he started his brand was that he couldn't find a job. And I feel like that's a big problem with fashion students coming out of school nowadays. As for the celebrities wearing Primos, you can find Anderson .Paak, Vic Mensa, Odell Beckham Jr., Kalani, Michelle Obama, Dua Lipa, the list goes on and on. He had a couple of fashion shows over the years, but in the 2020 collection, I really like the visuals, and you can tell that the show was well thought out.
Primarily, fashion's been like the thing that I've known for 18 years, and it's the thing that I've been doing consistently. But I do dabble, and I do like to show that I dabble in the way I present Pierre Moss. Pierre Moss is a culmination of fashion, music, art, language, societal critique, all of the things, you know, all of the things that have piqued my interest throughout my life.
Now let's take it back to 2016, the year that I really took him off. What I like about the runway fashion show is that you can see things out of the ordinary. The show was very unique. All the models had boots with tape wrapped around it, and you can see quotes like, "You don't have any friends in LA," or "Why so blue?" with boxed out images. Kerby Jean-Raymond also has a brand deal with Reebok, and I'm gonna be honest, I do not like Reeboks at all. I've ever only had one pair, and that was a while ago. The shoes are amazing. I really like the style. Now for my take. A very good reason why I like Kerby Jean-Raymond is that he keeps it real. When I say real, I mean real. Kerby Jean-Raymond knows how to design, he knows what he's talking about, and has a vision. That's what it means to be a designer.
I'm not speaking to anyone besides us. I'm not making work for white consumption. And that's not to say like I don't fuck with white people. I love everybody. But it's like if I did that, I'd be doing that myth that I told you earlier. Mm-hmm. Right? I can't speak to a community that I don't know. Mm-hmm. I'm just speaking to a community that I know. And what I'm showing is like, hey, this industry has been elitist for a long time. This industry has literally made their money, their fortunes, and bought their yachts and bought their mansions and everything off the backs of black consumerism and off the creative leeching of like urban and black and minority communities and LGBTQ communities, and like, and has never made the effort to represent them. Like, never made an effort to actually speak to them. It's like they've been creating like this aspirational lifestyle that like everyone has been going to, but at the same time it's been like fucking us up mentally. The illest Stockholm syndrome, you know what I mean? Like, we've been beaten down, like shown like this lifestyle that we just can't aspire to. And what Pierre Moss does different is actually show the real people in the ad campaigns, in the videos, on the runways, in the shoes, or actually buying the product and like showing them how they're beautiful. Like, we even doing like open studios. Like, after we do our shows, we do an open studio where we literally open it up for anyone to just come and just shoot the campaign in our clothes. We don't approach it from a place of like elitism. We approach it from a place of like, here, we're down here with you, and we can build this up together. This is a community problem.